Up church. Where all my married couples at? I know we got some married couples in here, especially the man of God. Clap it up if you're married and excited about it. Woo! Everybody married should be clapping. You got help with your bills. Woo! I got married because of the recession. I'm on. I seen the recession coming like it was the wind. I was like, is that the recession? Oh, I can't go in this alone, amen. Bible said it ain't good for man to be alone. And I think it's because of bills. You don't want you to have to pay that by yourself. Get you some help, son. Come on, son. Get some help, son. I needed me a wife. I was proactive, too. I didn't wait on nobody. Went straight to the pawn shop, but get me a ring first. That way I can be ready for it. People laugh. You went to the pawn shop. You went to the pawn shop. Think about it. At some point, somebody went to Jared. Just because it didn't work out for that relationship. Don't mean it won't work out for me and my queen. We praying about it. Amen. Should have prayed over it. Might have lasted. Amen. What was cold is I had bought a ring. Now I got a ring in my pocket. Nobody to ask. It was like it was burning a hole in my pocket. You had money in your pocket, no stones open. Started to be proactive. I said, you know what, I'm gonna just start asking people. Went downtown and every time the bus got off, hey, how you doing? I'm just trying to beat this recession. You trying to beat it with me? Like girls were doing that, laughing and stuff. Boy, I'm on my way to work. I was sitting there with the ring. I don't like your attitude anyways. Found me a lady though, man. Ooh. Found me a lovely young lady to get married to. And it was a blessing. But I didn't think we was gonna make it. Ain't nothing. Mm-mm, didn't start off good. You know, you ever met a Christian with Muslim tendencies? Love God, but hate pork. You know what I mean? Read the scriptures every day, but can't stand bacon. I didn't understand it. I thought it was a problem with her. You know? She told me she didn't eat bacon. I started backing away from her like she had a disease. You all right? You don't eat bacon, what? Hey, what's cold is the people that don't eat bacon, they always want to tell you why you shouldn't, right? Shouldn't eat bacon, eat worms, I ain't never done nothing. Eating bacon all my life. I mean, I got this little thing right here, but other than that, you know, I'm pretty healthy, you know. A lot of times it be them that got problems, you know. Got anxiety, can't sleep, need pills. I tried to tell her, I know what your problem is. You need a pork chop. No, you need a pork chop. Wrap it in bacon and call me in the morning. I bet you ain't sitting on it. She tried to sneak it on me too, you know what I mean? You ever take your girl out for a date? We went out for pizza. Went out for pizza. I went to the bathroom, came back, there was a pizza on the table already. It was a cheese pizza. I said, who sent this naked pizza out here? You ever seen a cheese pizza? Look all unattractive, man. Nobody ever fought over no cheese pizza, man. It looked all undone. I was like, what's wrong with this pizza? This pieology, we supposed to put it together? What are you thinking of that? This pizza ain't done, man. You ever see a pepperoni pizza? Don't it look like a party on that thing? Yeah. Pepperoni be dancing. You be like, I want the one with seven slices, man. Give me that one. Crazy. I didn't think we was gonna make it, man. It was rough. You know, there's a lot of times women, they always want to try to correct you, you know? Well. And a lot of times, it ain't that we don't got the answer, you just ask too fast. Right? Give me a minute. Where was you at? Huh? Huh? Yeah. Who you say you went with? What? What was the other day? Hmm? You gotta give us a minute, you know? Right. Give me a minute. I'm gonna tell you tomorrow who I was with. Why to try to hit me with some knowledge. You know what I'm talking about? The pieces, she's going to try to hit me with some knowledge. She's like, you know, Jesus cursed them pigs and then he sent them in the water. I said, well, I guarantee you snatched the bacon off first. Snatched the bacon right off of the pig. The pig feet came, the chitlins came with. I tried to tell her, by the time them pigs went in the water, wasn't nothing but the tail, man. The tail is bad. Jesus cursed that tail, and if you ever see somebody eating the tail, tell them, don't you do it. Jesus cursed that.
Mommy.
It was cold because she hit me with it so quick, and I was like, damn, dude. I'm going to hit her back with some knowledge because I'm smart. I seen the globe in the room. Took her over to the globe and I spent it. Stopped it on Africa. I said, all black people are supposed to be eating pork. Look at Africa and tell me that ain't shaped like a pork chop. Look at it, man. That is a pork chop. And you're missing vital nutrients not eating from the motherland. That's why you're sick now. She's gonna try to point out the Nile. I said, that is gravy, man. It means you can have gravy on your pork chop. She was fine though, man. Oh, my wife was beautiful. So I didn't, you know, I went without pork for a while. But just tried to do it, you know. We had a problem when the holidays came, you know. Going over to my auntie house. Oh, I was dreaming about that honey baked ham. Amen. I knew it was gonna be there. She gonna get mad at me because when we walked in, she thought I was looking at another girl.
Scary.
I ain't gonna lie, I walked in the house, I seen that honey baked ham, I was like, oh! Who is that with the pineapple on top? Who is that? And then she sliced already. You know, I tried to tell her, baby, I'm only cheating on you with the swine. I think I'm gonna spend the night. Oh man. You gotta be good to your wife though, man. You gotta be good to your wife. Fellas, right?
Yeah.
Good to your wives, man. Good to your wife, you get good facts. Happy wife is a happy life, amen. Man, I remember when, you know, when the relationship is good, man, everything is good, even the meat. Right? When your wife is cooking for her and she cooking with love, that meat tender. They be in the kitchen cooking with love. You can hear it. They be like, You know, switching the meat. She kicked off the heels just so she could do that move. Cooking with love, that meat is tender. Man, I remember I had ate some tender meat and it slide. You ever had some meat slide down your throat, you didn't get to taste it really? I was trying to eat it. Hey, baby, what was that? Hey, there ain't never enough tender meat either. Ain't no more. You looking at the kids, but y'all go to bed. You were good. Oh. But when you gave her attitude, oh, and she cooking with hate, oh, that's different meat, man. That meat go from tender to tough. Oh, you ever had some tough meat, man, to make you just chew all night long? And you don't even know, because tough meat cut like tender meat. I cut the meat out like, my baby love me. That was just chewing on. Right? That's it, That's good. Yeah. Start talking to yourself. You're like, I know I'm supposed to chew 40 times. You ever chew so long your jaws get tired? I had to pull the meat out of it. What are we eating, boy? Jaws hurt. I had messed around and my jaw had moved out like I was smoking crack. I was like, baby, my jaw. I was trying to hold it in and look like Bobby Brown. Oh Lord. I was trying to talk and it would just pop out. Oh. That's when I realized you can't be judging people. No, y'all see some.